Hawaii Island residents really bracing for Madeline this morning.
And officials have already made several closures ahead of the storm. All University of Hawaii campuses on the Big Island will be closed beginning today. All public schools are also closed today and tomorrow. 14 campuses have been turned into shelters, which are open.
Also, sections of the Hawaii Volcanoes National Park will be closed until the storms have passed. And hopefully folks get that message. Anybody interested in going to see Halemaumau right now, that is not the time. Bridget Namata is on Hawaii Island with more on preparations. Good morning, Bridget.
Hey, good morning to you guys. That's right. We are at Hawaii County Civil Defense Headquarters inside. It's a 24-hour operation, and we have got Mayor Billy Kanoi with us. Good morning.
Good morning again. Aloha.
Madeline, can you give us the latest update?
We're starting to see the same track. We're starting to be a little optimistic, but it's still concerning. It shows about at 10 a.m., 11 a.m., we'll start to see some impacts. We'll be within a zone of tropical storm, force winds at about 39 miles an hour. Mm-hmm. We're looking right now about 1 p.m. as being a time when we'll start to probably see the most impact from the east, southeast part of Hawaii Island.
Okay. And there are six monitors behind us. Can you kind of describe what we're looking at, especially right there in the middle? Is that a traffic monitor?
Yeah, what we have are traffic monitors that we can see from downtown Hilo out to Upper Puna, Lower Puna. Gives us an idea while we're here in the Emergency Operations Center, what it looks like outside, what kind of conditions we're seeing. We have different types of modeling, whether it's satellite imagery. Up high, we have our different indications of high pressure, low pressure systems. If you notice right now, you have a clockwise. When we see counterclockwise, as we see around Lester, we start to see low pressure systems. When we have a clockwise system, we have high pressure systems. Mm-hmm. If you look down in the lower end, our modeling from the National Weather Service shows a gradual weakening of Madeline in terms of wind speed. And we're also seeing a more southerly or southwesterly track. And that gives us a lot of hope and optimism that we'll see a lessening of an impact for Madeline upon our island and community.
What about emergencies? Have you guys had any reports of weather-related emergencies in regards to Hurricane Madeline?
We have just received recent reports that we've lost some electricity to a community on the Hamakua coast, Pauila Mauka. We have Helco responding to that right away and working as hard as they can to restore power.
And not just that area. Are there any other areas of the island that you're worried about in terms of really damaging effects from Hurricane Madeline?
Our concerns, based on the current modeling from National Weather Service, gives us concern on the eastern shoreline as well as the southeastern part of Hawaii Island, low-lying, shoreline, coastline areas. So residents in those areas have been notified. That gives us concern because it's a combination of the surge we're seeing in the oceans that are predicted, high surf that we're starting to see. When you add the wind and the rain to that, that's when we can really see some significant impact.
What's your message to those residents?
Continue to shelter in place, that we have shelters available for them, their families, pets as well. And that we just want everybody to keep off the roads, lessen any potential impact for accidents that might divert our first responder resources in the community.
Gotcha. And I do have another question. If people need help, who do they call and who do they not call?
We're all here available. In about an hour and a half, every agency, county, state, federal, and Hawaii Island will be in the room. We're here for coordination and communication purposes. Make sure if anybody needs any assistance or help, please give us a call at Hawaii County Civil Defense. We're here around the clock. The reason we have representatives from all the agencies is so that we can communicate immediately and get the needed resources out to people who need it most.
Okay, that's all the time we have. Thank you so much, Mayor.
You're very welcome. Aloha.
And again, we are live in Hilo giving you guys the latest updates, and we'll be here all day, all evening, giving you guys the latest information from Hilo. Back to you guys in studio.
All right. Thank you.
We will continue to bring you everything you need to know as Hurricanes Madeline and Lester approach. We'll have live reports all morning long from the Central Pacific Hurricane Center and the Big Island. You can also find the latest updates at khon2.com.